In this video, we will understand alternating current. As we know, when we allow electrons to flow through a wire or conductor, current is created in that conductor. The direction of this current is opposite to the flow of electrons. To make electrons flow, we connect one end of the wire to the positive terminal of a battery and the other end to the negative terminal. We observe that electrons flow from negative to positive, while the current flows from positive to negative. When the current flows in a single direction and its direction doesn't change with time, we call it direct current, DC. Now, if we interchange the ends of the wire, we see that the direction of electron flows and current reverses. If we repeat this process, the direction of electrons and current keeps reversing. If we repeat this process rapidly, the direction of current continuously changes, and we call it alternating current, AC. Generating alternating current is not possible with a simple battery. This is why we use an AC generator. To understand alternating current, you need to understand some related basic terms such as frequency, phase, and time period. Let's consider an AC generator connected to a bulb through a wire. We observe that the direction of current in the wire continuously changes, but the bulb continues to glow. Practically, we could not see this happening because this process is occurring very rapidly. If we represent the flow of current through a graph, we get a wave pattern. When the current starts flowing in the wire, its value is zero initially. It reaches its maximum value after a certain time interval, which we call the time period. We denote it as T. As soon as the current direction changes, the current value decreases and becomes zero again. In this wave pattern, the crest and trough represent the peak values of the current, which we denote as I0, Y giving it the time taken to complete one cycle is the time period T. This wave completes many cycles in 1 second, and the number of cycles completed in 1 second is called the frequency. We denote it as F. We represent the frequency as f is equal to 1 upon t. We can represent alternating current in the following way, where at any given particular time, the current has a value denoted as I0, which is the peak current. In this equation, omega is the angular frequency, whose value is equal to 2 pi by t. T represents the time period in which one cycle is completed. We can represent alternating current in its sine and cosine forms. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please like and subscribe our channel.